श्री हर्षवर्धन सिंह दुंगारपुर।
थैंक यू चेयरमैन सर। द यूनियन कैबिनेट चेयर्ड बाय प्राइम मिनिस्टर श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी हैज अप्रूव्ड द कमर्शियल कोर्ट्स कमर्शियल डिवीजन एंड कमर्शियल अपेलेट डिवीजन ऑफ हाई कोर्ट्स अमेंडमेंट बिल 2018 फॉर इंट्रोडक्शन इन द पार्लियामेंट सर। With the rapid economic development, there has been considerable increase in commercial activities and consequently a steep rise in commercial disputes at domestic and international level. Increase in FDI, foreign direct investment, and overseas commercial transactions have further contributed to a significant increase in commercial disputes. With a view to address the issue faster resolution of matters relating to commercial disputes and to create a positive image particularly among foreign investors and about independent and responsive Indian legal system. Sir, as mentioned before, some of the salient features are, of course, it brings down the specific value of a commercial dispute to 3 lakhs from the present 1 crore. Therefore, commercial disputes of a reasonable value can be decided by commercial courts, and this will bring down the time taken presently to say about 1,445 days in the resolution of commercial disputes of lesser value, and thus further improve India's ranking in the ease of doing business. The amendment provides for establishment of commercial courts at district judge level and commercial division in high courts. So the amendment will help the commercial courts to take up more cases and reduce pendency in the long run. So one of the claims also that counterclaims will not be transferred. Sir, previously under the Act, if a counterclaim was filed in a commercial dispute of at least 1 crore rupees in a civil court, the civil court could transfer the suit to a commercial court. The ordinance removes this provision in relation to transfer of suits. Sir, ease of doing business is an index of World Bank, which inter alia refers to disputes resolution environment in a country, which facilitates the investors in deciding for setting up of an operation of a business. The index has been created by World Bank Group since 2002. So it has been evaluating almost all the countries of the world. So on 31st October 2017, the World Bank released its annual Ease of Doing Business report for the year 2018, in which India has emerged out as among top 10 improvers for the first time ever since, as our union minister just mentioned, India has jumped 30 positions to reach 100th ranked country in terms of ease of doing business amongst 190 countries. This manifests that India is fast adopting the best practices and regulatory framework for the ease of doing business. So with this, I support the bill.
Thank you, Ashwadhanji.